Hello Gundam fans, this is Brian92, and today I'll be looking at the 100 Type X mask set for the... Well, it says Master Grade Exia and Astraea, and I got them all came from Gundam Central. Link is in the description below. So this is from SJL, which I think I've built kits from them before. They're add-on, another company that does add-on stuff. This one... I'm gonna be right off the bat, it's not that good. Unfortunately, I really wish it was. Some part, the construction of the plastic is not up to snuff. You can modify it a little bit, but the thing is, the connections to the model kits I have here is really weird. So let's start with what you get, okay? You get a face mask. First off, there's two variants. There's the red one and the white one. So, normal Astraea, Astraea F-type. We'll talk about that. But here it is, the face mask. You have the clear green for the sensor. You also get a normal clear for the parts. So if you want to, like, paint the parts a different color than green, you can totally do it. Because the parts that this was taken from was the metal build Astraea X, I think it was. Which, it's like a gray, and the parts are clear purple. So, like, this makes more sense for these variants. But if you wanted to do one that's purple, you can just paint the clear. It works. You get two of the Astraea shields. You get two of the Exia shields. And you also get two of the Jinx Astraea shields. Which are cool looking. You get two of the sniper rifles. Assuming that's what they are. And you also get connectors to make it like so it can connect to the backpack. Like here. Here is one configuration you can do. You get little clips that hook up to these indents around the sniper rifles. You can click it, like connect it to the shield, because the shields have two ports. And then this part just goes into the back. You have to remove the back panel and just peg it into the back. I've got ones like this before for other Xs, like, well, the ones I have here. Because they're using another add-on set that I have. So you can just attach it. They go onto the G and drive, where the other one goes into the back. Now, on to the actual parts. This is where things go weird. First off, this is the Hobby Star Exia, but it is based off the Master Grade. It doesn't work with the face mask, because the cheeks are a little too big. And you could probably modify it. But as far as I can tell straight off the bat, doesn't really attach. And of course, there's nowhere to clip these shields onto the arms because it has the G and condensers on the arms. So that doesn't really work. So, Exia is, as far as I can tell, at least with the modifications, kinda, it's not gonna work. Now the metal build Astraea from Japan. This is another weird thing. The face mask, once again, will not fit, and it's because these two little pegs inside here, which they basically, you have to take off the V-fin and the top of the head, and so this little peg into the top, and then these two taps are supposed to peg into where the V-fin goes, but the thing is, the metal build V-fin, the way it plugs in, see, it's these pegs are too far apart to go in there, so you'd have to modify that. It would fit, I think, if you actually cut those pegs off, and maybe just the friction of the going onto the top here. That would probably do the job. But the cool thing is, the shields do work. So you can easily peg those in without a problem, and they look good. Although I do find, see, they're supposed to open up. If I take the Astraea ones, which are all white, these are on hinges. They work fine, so they spread open. But the center part's supposed to pull out and rotate. It's too tight. Like, you'd have to, like, modify the peg so it's thinner, so you can pull it out. But as it is, it doesn't open up too well. So what I'm doing is I'm going to leave the white one closed and the red one open. Because why not? Also, the Astraea and Exia shields, not that well constructed. They're very loose. You'd have to glue them all together, or and modify some of the ports to make them so they're actually smooth and conform, but other kits have been released with those, so it's not really that interesting. I have way too many of these shields, really. Now, the Hobby Star. Well, it works, and it doesn't, just like with the Metal Bolt. If I bring in my Astraea F-Type Hobby Star, which I have the G and cannon attached to it, the mask fits perfectly. It seems that the mask was designed for the Hobby Star, so it'll work with the white and the red. And the hands work perfectly. They're the fixed post hands, so you have to like take it apart, but they peg in perfectly into the hand and into the arm. But the peg for the shields were made for the Metal Build, and these are way too thick to go into the ports on the arms, which means you're going to have to modify the peg to go into the, for the shield. So you can put the mask on the Hobby Star and the shields on the Metal Build, but not both without doing some modification. It's really, really weird. Now the sniper rifle will also peg into the Metal Build hand and into the arm. So the rifles work on basically any variant, apparently. Although they aren't assembled very well. Like I said, the quality of the plastic is not the best. The connections are not very good either. So you'd have to kind of modify it to make it look good. But they can be in the hands, and they can be mounted on the arms. And finally, the backpack. Because it has the extra piece up, so it's supposed to pick into the inner frame of the Astraea or Exia. Now this is, once again, the Hobby Star. The Metal Build will not work, because the Metal Build is not designed like the normal Master Grade. And this barely works. It's like a big gap. It pegs in, but it doesn't hold, so I'd have to glue it into the body. And it's only holding right now because the armor is attached. So, once again, you're going to have to do some modifications if you want this to work. So this is kind of a disappointing set. I'm going to use it. I'm going to use it with this guy here, and probably the white one with this armor. Actually, let me just put that on right now so you can see how it works, because it does work with the Hobby Star. If you yank your head off. So the face mask goes into the holes where the V-pin was. The top part goes and pegs onto the head, top of the head. And then this will just kind of sandwich it all together. Like that. And even there you can see the whites are not quite the same. This is more of a pure white. The Astraea from Hobby Star is a little more off-white. But that's how you do it. It's pretty simple. It holds. And it does look pretty cool. I do like it. But once again, I can't attach the shields, Astraea X shields, onto these arms without modifying either the hole. But I'm going to modify the peg, because I don't want to wreck the arms there and not be able to put anything else on them, aside from the shields. So, they tried, and they succeeded in certain areas. Like I said, some things worse for the Hobby Star, or the Master Grade, because it is based off the official Master Grade. And some work for the Metal Build, but mostly just the shields. So, if you have both of these, like I do, both versions, you can totally use this set here and there. But if you have just like, oops. If you have just one, or if you have the Master Grade Astraea F-Type, which is coming out, you should be able to use the face mask. You're going to have to modify the arms, probably. But it's an option. Not a big fan of this. I wish it was better. I'm going to use the Astraea Jinx parts, but they definitely needed to think a little more about what they were doing here. Anyways, that's about it. If you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.